G'day ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Draw with Jazza. I'm Jazza and this is the Artist Showcase video series where once a week I look at the art that people send me and I've reviewed it all and I pick about a dozen or so to show in a video, and one of them is featured on the front page of Newgrounds every week. So to all the people who have sent me artwork, I have hundreds to look at, so I'm often a week or two behind and I'm still trying to catch up, and it's gonna be a little hard for me to catch up to them properly this week and the week after because I am in a theatre production of Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat, where I play Joseph, and I am very, very busy. So things are quite chaotic. That aside, you might also notice that I have a little bit of a tan and some eye makeup that I can't fully remove. That's all part of the show, so please just kind of ignore how strange I might or might not look. But ladies and gentlemen, if you are well behaved, I might even upload some photos and a video of me singing one of the songs from the musical, just to kind of show what else I do in my spare time. Otherwise, jumping straight into this, we're going to look at our first piece, which is by artist Benalki, and it's a piece called Tsukiko. This piece shows quite a bit of improvement compared to the other artwork that has been sent to me by this user, and in particular it's just really refined. There's some nice line work, really simplistic shading, and the composition of the image is really pretty simple, but it's all done in a way that's really clearly communicated and quite slick, and it looks like a really nice finished production. So great work there, Benalki. Next piece by artist Londoness is called Sky is the Limit. It's got a really nice painterly feel about it, especially when you zoom in the sky in particular. And the figure at the bottom, while a bit glared out at some points and a little difficult to see, overall has a really nice aesthetic and brings out that shiny feeling and a really nice feeling of open space. So that's a nice one to share. Next piece by artist Ads Tony Gladvane is called Fairy, and it's quite a simplistic sort of piece. It's more in the flat colors and outline sort of artwork, but it's the little thing that caught me with this, the fact that her reflection is a little Tweety Bird. And I know that's such a small thing, but I mean, I go through a lot of images and many are very similar, and it's always just kind of the little things that are attentions to detail or little quirks in an image that kind of catch me and are really nice to kind of be like, oh, I see what you did there. That was a good job there. So I thought that was a bit clever, and I'm not going to say the name again because it's a long one, but congratulations. Next piece by artist Tat Loco is called Big Bad Wolf, and it was drawn on a Galaxy Note 10.1 using Sketchbook Pro. We've featured something from this artist before. This one is turned the right way as opposed to the other one, but overall it's got this really nice aesthetic to it. I don't know how that this person gets the level of detail that they do with the Sketchbook Pro images that they work with, because I've tried to draw on an iPad and it is extremely difficult. But that aside, great work and thank you for sharing. Next piece by artist Random Barryman is called Battle Worn. Now, we've featured an artwork from this artist before, which won one of the features, but this one is a little different because he said for the very first time he's drawing without using any references at all. And I think that is really cool to see, because aside from the fact that we've seen that this person obviously has some good talent, we can see them challenging themselves and getting some good results too. And that always deserves a good thumbs up. So congratulations, Random Barryman. It's looking really good, and I look forward to seeing what else you do in the future. Next piece by artist Reg Vita is called Artwork One. Quite a creative title. It's again quite simplistic. It's drawn traditionally with, I think, pen and pencil, but overall it's got a kind of nice sort of aesthetic. I like the color between the dark tones to the white of the blue and the jacket, and it's just kind of like an interesting way of shading it. So I thought that was interesting to look at and worth sharing. It's quite simple, but overall quite good to look at. So good job there. Next piece by artist Mastering Anime is called Kakashi, and it was drawn on an iPad using Sketchbook, and I said previously in this video already how frustrating that can be, but the fact that this person got this result is well worth a feature in its own right, because that takes time and patience that I don't have. Fantastic work. Considering you did that on an iPad, I am very impressed, so keep it up, and I'm looking forward to seeing what else you can do on an iPad, because that must be difficult. Our next piece by artist CMSDC is called David Gandy Portrait, and it's got a really nice sort of drawn feel. When you zoomed in, you can see the roughness of the line work and the way the strokes are used, but when you zoomed out, it's almost kind of photo quality. So I would imagine that there's been a reference at use here, but again, zooming in, I just love it when you can see things are really kind of quite roughly put together in a way that overall gives a really hand-touched and realistic quality about it. So fantastic work there. Next piece by artist DYB is called Irish Leprechaun, and it's got a really cool mix of colours and a really cheeky sort of feel about the picture overall. I love the expression of the character. I love the way the colours mix. The really bright orange and the really bright green oppose yet complement each other really well, and the figure is really strong. It's just kind of a fun image to look at that I thought I'd share with you, so thank you for sharing that with us, DYB. Next piece by artist Boyka A is called Pikachu, and it is this person's very first digital painting again. I always like to feature a first digital painting in each showcase episode. I don't feature all of them, so don't just send me a picture and say it's my first digital painting because you expect to be featured, but if it shows some potential, and especially if they've uploaded other works that might be traditional artwork or kind of, I can see that they keep painting or things like that, it kind of persuades me to be like, good job. So thank you for sharing that with us, Boyka A, and keep it up. And the last piece that we're sharing today and our feature of the week on the front page of Newgrounds is by The Silent Dane, and it's called Sci-Fi Suit. Now, the best way I can describe how I feel about this image is that it gets two things very right. The first thing is simplicity, and the second thing is complexity. And I know that sounds a little weird and contrasting, but the overall image is really simple. I mean, it's quite simple. It's a character standing there. There's not too much detail. There's nothing really in the background, but the complexity is really apparent too. The way that there is a clear understanding that this person has of how light shines on metal and where shadow falls on the character standing in that pose and from where the light is communicated, and that there is no hesitation in having dark and light and having them work against and for each other. And the overall silhouette of the image is really solid. The understanding of anatomy and perspective in the image itself is really strong, and it communicates a lot without forcing that communication. It's really clear and simple, and I think that deserves a great big thumbs up, and I really look forward to seeing what else this person can do. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for joining our showcase this week. Remember to send me your artwork on newgrounds.com, and until next time, I will see you later. Do you want me to review your artwork and have a chance to be in a future showcase video? Upload your artwork to newgrounds.com. You can send me a link by going to jazza.newgrounds.com and click send a private message. Make sure to include the word showcase in capital letters in the message title and give me a link to your piece of art. Please be considerate of my time and understand I have a lot to get through, so please only send me one image and not a whole gallery, and make sure that it's on newgrounds.com. Thanks for checking out this showcase. I look forward to seeing your art in the future.